Our service continues in your leaflet. We're glad you are here. Let us pray. Almighty God, almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Shout out, do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day they seek me and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgment. They delight to draw near to God. Why do we fast, but do you not see? Why humble ourselves, but you do not notice? Look, you serve your own interests on your fast day and oppress all of your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this fast a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin, then your light shall break forth like the dawn and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong. And you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Please join me in reading Psalm 103 that's in your leaflet. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and of great kindness. He will not always accuse us, and nor will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so is his mercy great upon those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our sins from us. As a father cares for his children, so does the Lord care for those who fear him. For he himself knows whereof we are made. He remembers that we are but dust.
We entreat you on behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain, for he says, "At an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation." We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commanded ourselves in every way, through great endurance, and afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors, and yet are true, as unknown, and yet are well known, as dying, and see we are alive, as punished, and yet not killed, as sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. Here, the Spirit is saying to us,
thanks be to God.
Happy Ash Wednesday! And I say Happy Ash Wednesday not
because this is also a season where our collective worries and woes and griefs come to rise. When I was early in my ministry and was celebrating Ash Wednesday, I went to the local farmer's market. And I was at the Indian food stand, and the gentleman there said, "What is this you've got on there?" And I didn't know how to say it except to say, "We say the words, 'Remember you are dust, and to dust you shall return.'" And he got excited. He said, "That's like my religion. Remember we are dust, and to dust we shall return." I was hearing that the cultural reference for Lent is McDonald's fish fillet. Those fish Fridays, I guess. Growing up Episcopalian, didn't know that that was a thing until I became an adult. But our idea of Lenten discipline, of preparing the way, of sifting through, still comes through. And in our gospel lesson, we hear what we do for show. What we do to show others. And in this Sermon on the Mount, Jesus says, do it for God. Not to show, but to listen and to learn. And I invite us in this Lent not to rush towards what we will be doing. Many of our hearts are heavy. Many of us have been living in this in-between time, I think all of us. And what is not included in our text for today in the gospel lesson is the Lord's Prayer. So if you are wondering what to do, maybe Fish Fridays is your thing, more power to you. But come back to the Lord's Prayer. And I invite you to take your leaflet with you, your bulletin, and to set aside time. Whether you open your prayer book or your Bible, and particularly our lesson from Isaiah. Is this not the fast that I choose? To loose the bonds of injustice, to let the oppressed go free. Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not hide yourself from your own kin. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and God will say, "Here I am." So let us reflect on what our true treasures are. Let us listen more deeply. Instead of racing the course, to go slow and steady. And let us set aside time for God and for one another, and let that light break forth. Amen. Dear people of God, the first Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection, and it became the custom of the church to prepare for them by a season of penitence and fasting. This season of Lent provided a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. It was also a time when those who, because of notorious sins, had been separated from the body of the faithful, were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness, and restored to the fellowship of the church. Thereby, the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution set forth in the gospel of our Savior, and of the need which all Christians continually have to renew their repentance and faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the Church, to the observance of a holy Lent, by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, by reading and meditating on God's holy word, and to make a right beginning of repentance as a mark of our mortal nature. Let us now kneel or stand before the Lord, our Maker and Redeemer. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be to us a sign of our mortality and penitence, and that we may remember that it is only by your gracious gift that we are given everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. I welcome you. Thank you. Holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and to the whole communion of saints in heaven and on earth that we have sinned by our own fault in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have done. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. Have mercy on us, Lord. We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit. Have mercy on us, Lord. We confess to you, Lord, all of our past unfaithfulness, the pride and hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives. We confess to you, Lord, our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people. We confess to you, Lord, our anger at our own frustration and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves. We confess to you, Lord, our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts, and our dishonesty in daily life and work. We confess to you, Lord, our negligence in prayer and worship, and our failure to commend the faith that is in us. We confess to you, Lord. Accept our repentance, Lord, for the wrongs we have done, for our blindest human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty. Accept our repentance, Lord, for all false judgments, for uncharitable thoughts towards our neighbors, and for our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us. Accept our repentance, Lord, for our waste and pollution of your creation and our lack of concern for those who come after us. Accept our repentance, Lord. Restore us, good Lord, and let your anger depart from us. Favorably hear us, for your mercy is great. Accomplish in us the work of your salvation, that we may show by the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord, bring us with all of your saints to the glory of his resurrection. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desires not the death of sinners, but rather that they may turn from the wickedness and live, has given power and commandments to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardons and absolves all those who truly repent and with sincere hearts believe his holy gospel. Therefore, we beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do on this day, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come into his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, Creator of heaven and earth. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Creator, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you now and always.